فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The author رحمه الله, he goes and now and speaks about تمييز. He speaks about التمييز. تمييز in the language, it means فصل الشيء عن غيره. تمييز means is to distinguish something from any other thing. So it's to basically distinguish between things. According to the grammarians, okay, تمييز is of two types. And the type in which the author defined here, which is والاسم المنصوب المفسر لمن انبهم من الذوات, it is the first type, which is called تمييز الذات. So he defines the first type of the تمييز, which is called تمييز الذات. And تمييز الذات, as you can all see, is basically, it's basically that you are clarifying and you are basically explaining an essence of something, an object, or an essence is what you are basically distinguishing here. That's the first one. And it occurs in the second form as تمييز النسبة. تمييز النسبة basically means what you are removing is the amount of you're distinguishing an amount in something. For example, you'll say تسبب زيد عرقا. Okay, here you're saying that زيد sweated. Okay, the word تسبب, what does it mean? تسبب, تسبب is basically to pour, to bring out. So he's excreting, he's bringing out. Okay, زيد عرقا, عرقا is sweat. Okay, now this here عرقا is basically to explain the sweat of Amr, the quantity of it. So it's basically trying to say that he came with this in a very, but it's not an object that you're talking about here. And you're not talking about an essence, okay? You're basically talking about the sweat. That's the second type, which the author, rahimahullah, did not bring about. He only defined, when he defined, تمييز الذات. Are you with me, brothers? The author then gave examples. He said, تسبب زيد عرقا. تسبب زيد عرقا falls into what? تمييز النسبة, and it's not really تمييز الذات. It's incorrect for him to define تمييز الذات and bring an example for تمييز النسبة. So this is deficiency on the side of the author. Also تفقع بكر شحما. Again, this is a what? تمييز تمييز النسبة. نعم. And the author also mentions the conditions of تمييز. He mentioned two conditions. وَلَا يَكُونُ إِلَّا نَكَرَةً وَلَا يَكُونُ إِلَّا بَعْدِ تَمَامِ الْكَلَمِ. Okay? The first one is أَنْ يَكُونَ نَكَرَةً. It has to be نَكَرَةً. That was the first condition. It can't be مَعْرِفَةً. It can't be مَعْرِفَةً. The second one is أَلَّا يَكُونَ إِلَّا بَعْدِ تَمَامِ الْكَلَمِ. It has to be after the speech is over. Meaning after you've explained and you've spoken about the complete sentence. So the two conditions that he mentions. There are also other conditions that the scholars mention, which he has not brought. So one more time. The تمييز is two types. تمييز ذات. The second one is called تمييز نسبة. تمييز ذات, the thing that makes it منصوب is two things. The thing that makes it منصوب is two things. The first thing is al-adad, the amount. And the second thing is the miqdar, adad, now number, and the miqdar, which is the amount. And as you know, the miqdar is three types. Waznu, kail, and masaha. Wazn, kail, and the masaha. Those three are what? They are the factors that basically cause it. So for example, if you say اشتريت 20 غلاما, that's a number. وملكت 90 نعجة, which the author brought, is also a what? Are you with me, brothers? Is the tamiz of what? Tamiz of that adad. The miqdar is three types, as I said. It's wazn, which is weight. Okay? For example, you say, ishtaraytu ritlan asalan. Asal. And the second one is, kail. Ishtaraytu sa'an daqiqan. And a masaha, which is the distance. Ishtaraytu mitran hariran. The second type, which is tamizu nisba, tamizu and nisba, it comes from three forms that the author mentions. It's basically, it's transferred from three things. The first one is a fa'il and a maf'ul and a mubtada. That's the muhawwal, that's the form that is actually transferred. There's a type that's not transferred within the tamizu nisba. So in other words, look at this example. تصبب زيد عرقا. Originally, what was it? تصبب عرق زيد. That's what it was. Are you with me, brothers? تصبب عرق زيد. It was used to be. It got transferred from what? It got transferred from being فاعل. Are you there? And it turned out to be the, so it's, the tamiz here is transferred from the fa'il. It used to be ta'az tasabbaba irqu zaydan. Are you with me? Who is doing the tasabbub here? The irq is doing it, which is the sweat. So now the tamiz is from that fa'il. So that's why now you're saying tasabbaba zaydun irqan. Araqan. Are you with me, brothers? Araqan. It can also be taken from a maf'ul bih, like qawluhu ta'ala, وَفَجَّرْنَا الْأَرْضَ عُيُونَا. It used to be, وَفَجَّرْنَا الْعُيُونَ الْأَرْضِ. Are you with me? So, عُيُون here is what? It's taken from a عُيُونَ. عُيُون is what? Maf'ul bih. It's taken from that. And now it became a tamiz. It can also be taken from a mubtada. Originally the sentence was a mubtada. كَقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى. Like the statement of Allah. أَنَا أَكْثَرُ مِنْكَ مَالًا. Originally was what? مَالِي أَكْثَرُ مِنْ مَالِكِ. So مَال here is what? Originally it comes from a mubtada, which is مَالِي, my wealth. أكثر is more than your wealth. And here we find that the mal here is what? The mal here is a mubtada. And in the ayah is a tamiz, which is أنا أكثر منك مالا. It's tamiz. Now.
How وحاشا فالمستثنى بإلا ينصب إذا كان الكلام تاما موجبا نح قام القوم إلا زيدا وخرج الناس إلا عمرا وإن كان الكلام منفيا تاما جاز فيه البدل والنصب على الاستثناء نح ما قام القوم إلا زيد وإلا زيدا وإن كان الكلام ناقصا كان على حسب العوامل نح ما قام إلا زيد وما ضربت إلا زيدا وما مررت إلا بزيد والمستثنى بغير وسوى مجرور لا غير والمستثنى بخلا وعدا وحاشا يجوز نصبه وجره نح قام القول خلا زيدا وزيد وعدا عمرا وعمر وحاشا بكرا وبكر.
The author, rahimahullah, he goes into the chapter called istithna. And in the Arabic language, linguistically, or in the lexical usage, the word istithna means mutlaqul ikhraj. It's basically when you take something out from a unrestricted. Basically, istithna means restriction. is when you restrict something. Okay? Is مطلق الإخراج. It is what? It is مطلق الإخراج. According to the Nahwiyin, there are adawat, letters that can be used that actually indicate and show that this word of yours is removing something from the unrestricted and it's restricting it now. And it is eight. Eight, which the author mentions. There are eight. And they are categorized, those eight, we can categorize them into three types. Those eight, which the author mentioned, we can categorize it into three types. The first type is those which are huruf bittifaq. They are letters, they're particles by consensus. According to grammarians, they all are consensus. And it's the word illa. Illa is a harf bittifaq, by consensus. And the second type is ism. It's a noun by consensus, and there are four. Like the word ghayr, and siwa, and suwa, and sawa'un. All four of those are nouns by consensus. Grammarians don't differ on that. The third type is mutaraddid bayn al-harfiyyah wal-fi'liyyah. There is this pull and push, whether it's a particle or whether it's a verb. And they are three. It is khala, ada, and hasha. These three are disputed whether they are harf or whether they are verbs. And inshallah ta'ala, when we come to mutammimatul ajrul or even qatrul nada, we'll start bringing the madahibs. In mutammimah, we won't really talk about the madahibs and the beliefs that they have in regards to grammar. You see, it will just complete off what ajrumiyyah left. But when we come to qatrul nada, we'll start to say this is madhabu Fulan, and this is the madhab of Fulan, and this khilaf is based on this, and we do tarjihat in qatr al-nada wa ballu al-sada. That's what the author mentions, and then he goes on to speak about the ruling of the mustathna that falls after illa. So if he says fal mustathna bi illa, are you with me, brothers? The author goes in to speak about the ruling of the mustathna bi illa. Are you with me, brothers? Brothers, are you with me? And he categorizes it into four. The author, rahimahullahu ta'ala, he categorizes it into four. What four? Four of the ruling of the mustathna. Mustathna means what, brothers? It's the noun that falls after the illa. Okay? It is ismu alladhi yadhkuru ba'da adatu al-istithna. Are you with me, brothers? The mustathna that falls after illa. It's what comes after illa. It's four types. The first one is yunsabu wujuban. It's wajib to place nasb on it. It's wajib that you place a nasb on it. You have to make it mansub. Remember, we're talking about mansubat al-asma' here. So it has to be mansub, wajib. But when is that? إِذَا كَانَ الْكَلَامُ قَبْلَهُ تَامًا مُوجِبًا. But that's with the condition that the speech is complete. Complete and it necessitates it. What do we mean by complete and necessitates? So he says here, tam and mujiban. What does he mean by tam? And what does he mean by mujib? Tam, what he means is for that the mustathna minhu is mentioned. The mustathna minhu is mentioned. We're going to see examples for that, don't worry. And pay attention, which is mujib. What does it mean, mujaban? What does it mean to be mujab? ما لا يسبقه نفي أو شبه. Negation shouldn't go before it. For example, you can't say, what you can say is قام القوم إلا زيدا. قام القوم إلا زيدا. Okay. وخرج الناس إلا عمرا. That's what the author brought, right? Now, if you look at Zayd and Amr, both of them are mansub wajib. It's obligatory to be made mansub. The reason is because the kalam is, both of them are complete. Because the mustathna minhu is mentioned. What's the mustathna minhu here? Qawm. Okay? In the first one is قَامَ الْقَوْمُ إِلَّا زَيْدًا. And the second example, خَرَجَ النَّاسُ. The mustathna minhu is what? The people. Are you with me? And it is obligatory to do it because لَمْ يَتَقَدَّمْهُ نَفْيٌ. A negation did not go before them, as is apparent. So brothers, that's important. The second one that the author mentions is if it goes before it. وَإِنْ كَانَ الْكَلَامُ الَّذِي قَبْلَ إِلَّا. If the speech before إِلَّا is negation, مَنْفِيًّا تَامًا, it's a complete negation, then this time it's not wajib, it's not obligatory. Here is called jawaz, it's permissible. So for example, we had the author brought, remember before, قَامَ الْقَوْمُ إِلَّا زَيْدًا, right? Let's put a negation before it. مَا قَامَ الْقَوْمُ إِلَّا زَيْدًا. You can say إِلَّا زَيْدًا or you can say إِلَّا زَيْدٌ. No problem here. يَجُوز. That's permissible and that's permissible. Are you with me, brothers? Yeah, illa illa. We're only talking about illa, by the way. We are talking about al-mustathna bi-illa. That's the only thing. حكم المستثنى بإلا. Okay, we're not talking about غير and سوى. We're going to come to those. سوى and سوى and سوى. We're going to come to that. We will, inshallah ta'ala. And خلا and حاشا and عادا. We're still on the first one. The third one is, it's wajib al-nasb. It's obligatory to place a nasb on it. But that's with what? والواجب في المستثنى is المنقطع, the disconnected one. It's disconnected. It's actually what? It's actually disconnected. For instance, when you say, as the author, I think he brought that example, what did he say? For example, he didn't bring it. An example will be, if you say, مَا قَامَ الْقَوْمُ, the people did not stand, إِلَّا فَرَسًا, except the horse. The horse is not part of the people. And this is called istithna munqata', is disconnected. Because what you're talking about is humans, and you brought a horse in, so it's disconnected. So this exception of yours is actually going towards something else, not qawm. It's disconnected from qawm, unless... Are you with me, brothers? This is wajib to do it. So you have to say illa farasan. Well, remember, when you hear... This, by the way, brothers, it goes back to usul al-fiqh as well. Are you with me, brothers? The jins of what your the mustathna minhu, the jins that we have here right now, is it, what is it? Humans. And what you did was you brought the mustathna, sorry, the jins is different to the mustathna minhu, right? Are you with me, brothers? The faras is not from the mustathna minhu, which is the qawm. Are you with me, brothers? So for this is called munqata', it's disconnected. It means the muhayya munqata' means khilaf, it's opposite. That's the second. But that's wajib for you to place a... You have to make a mansub. It's wajib and mansub. No, it's nephew. It's with negation and it's also munqata'. You with me? Which one? That's wajib.
So that's wajib and this is wajib.
This is wajib. They're both wajib. What is wujub like it? It is tam al-mujab. We talked about this is naqis al-mujab. So this is munqati', sorry, it's disconnected. We're now going to go to the fourth one, which is the last one. for al-mustathna bi-illah. And that is al-naqis. That is al-naqis. Naqis here, which is the last one that the author mentions, are you with me, brothers? Is the one he says, وَإِنْ كَانَ الْكَلَامُ النَّاقِصًا كَانَ عَلَى حَسَبِ الْعَوَامِلِ. This is in accordance to the awamil, the agents. Are you with me, brothers? And here, the awamil are what? The awamil are basically مَا قَامَ إِلَّا زَيْدٌ, which is رفع على فاعلية. You're making it مرفوع because of it being a فاعل. Or you make it mansoor based upon it being maf'ul. So you say, ضربت إلا زيدًا, as though it's a maf'ul به now. And of course, or you make it a جر بالحرف حرف بالحروف الجري. So you say, ما مررت إلا بزيدٍ. إلا بزيدٍ. And this one, scholars, they call it مفرغًا. Or ملغات. Or ناقص. All of them are the same. Now we go to the مستثنى منه. And the مستثنى, which is with غير and سوى and سوى. This one, the حكم for this one is, so والمستثنى بغير وسوى 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 مجرور لا غير. It's مجرور, nothing else. The last one, which is المستثنى بخلا وحاشانا, is two types, جواز النسبي and جواز الجري. The author mentions it for you. والمستثنى بخلا وعادا وعدا وحاشا يجوز نصبه وجره. So you can say which of the two you wish. You can say قام القوم خلا زيدا or خلا زيد, عدا عمرا وعمر, حاشا بكرا وبكر. Both are permissible for you. Are you with me, brothers? But if it happens that the ma mazdariya goes before it, then it becomes obligatory for you to make it mansoob. For example, qama al-qawmu ma khala. If you say Muhammad, you have to say, and the rest is the same. Okay. The author now here goes into لا, and the حكم of لا النافية للجنس, أنها لا تعمل النصب إلا في اللفظ إلا في اللفظ المركري اسما لها والرفع في الخبر خبرا لها. That the لا النافية للجنس, the لا that negates a essence. What is negating is an essence. That one, what it does is, it doesn't do the job of a nasb in a wording. لا تنصب النكرات. It doesn't place nasb on the nakirat. بغير تنوين, without a تنوين. If it like it does, it is bashir. ولم تتكرر, and it doesn't repeat. It doesn't come. So this author mentioned four conditions. The first condition is أن يكون اسمها نكرة, that its noun is a نكرة. Second one is أن يكون مباشرا لها, that it is what? Connected to it straight away. The third one is also its خبر is نكرة as well. And the fourth one is وأن لا تتكرر, it shouldn't repeat, it shouldn't come many times. That's when it works as the اسم منصوبات الأسماء. With those four conditions, which is the first one is لا رجل. رجل here is what? Is a اسم which is نكرة. It's also what? مباشرة is right after it. Nothing gets between لا رجل. Fourth one is that the خبر has to also be نكرة. The خبر has to also be نكرة. وألا تتكرر. The لا should not repeat itself so many times. نعم.
فإن لم تباشرها وجب الرفع ووجب التكرار لا ووجب التكرار لا نحو لا في الدار رجل ولا امرأة ولا امرأة فإن تكررت جاز إعمالها وإلغاؤها فإن شئت قلت لا رجل في الدار ولا امرأة وإن شئت قلت لا رجل في الدار ولا امرأة.
The author here is basically trying to say to you that if it misses a condition from the four aforementioned conditions, so any of those four conditions, if one of them is missing, for example, it misses the word rajul, something gets in between the two of them. It's not direct, basically, something is getting in between the two. If that's what happens, then in that situation, the la, its job is a wujub raf'uhu, alana mubtada muakhar. So it's working as though that it's obligatory to make it marfu', it's obligatory to make it marfu' as though it's what? A mubtada which is delayed. Or a jar wa majrur before it, it is the khabar which is muqaddam. And the ismu la is three types: mufrad, mudaf, shabihu bil mudaf. And we'll take all of those three, inshaAllah ta'ala, in the mutammimatul ajrumiyyah. Now, the four conditions: ayyakuna ismuha nakira, its noun has to be indefinite. Number two is ayyakuna mubashiran laha, that it is stuck to it straight away. It means alla yafsila baynahuma fasil, there should not be something that gets in between the two of them. And third is وَأَنْ يَكُونَ خَبَرَهَا, that the khabar is نَكِرَ كَذَلِكَ, that the third one is that the khabar is also a نَكِرَ. The fourth one is وَأَلَّا تَتَكَرَّرْ, and it shouldn't repeat itself. And the اسم لا is three types, مفرد, مضاف, شبيه بالمضاف. The مضاف and the شبيه بالمضاف, both of them are إعراب بالنصب. But if it's if the ism of la, ism la, if it is mufrad, it is mabniyun ala nasbi. It is what? Mabniyun ala nasbi. Now, but that we're going to speak about it in the other books to come. Right?